Good morning, dear friends, and today we're going to make ham and beans. Now I know I have a couple other videos on canning ham and beans, but I'm just going to make a fresh pot for our dinner, and I'm going to give the leftovers to my son and his wife and their family. So we're not going to can today, but I just thought it would be fun to kind of go through the process with you. We have our leftover Easter ham, some onion, about one onion chopped. We're going to use a couple cloves of garlic, a couple stalks of the celery, or ribs, I guess you'd say. The stalk would be the whole thing. And I have some baby carrots on hand. And I am soaking some white beans. You could use whatever beans you like. And if you don't want to bother with making beans that are dried, you know, having to soak them and all that, just get yourself 3 or 4 cans of beans. That works too. And we're going to use our new toy, our instant Dutch oven, and we're going to let this just cook on the slow cooker function the whole day. So let's get started. And I'll list all the ingredients in the description box below, and I'll also include a link to the instant Dutch oven in case you're interested in that. I'm going to use these are actually from 2021. I made some stock with beef and ham bones, and I've never used these. So I'm going to use those today rather than just using water, but you can just put water in with your ham bone, or you can use chicken stock if you'd like, whatever you want to do. But I'm going to use my my pre-made beef and ham stock, and I'll add a little extra water to it, but that'll give it a nice bit of extra boost of flavor. Okay, friends, this is going to be quick. You don't actually have to pre-soak your beans. I do soak them for about an hour when I'm going to slow cook them the rest of the day, but you don't really have to. You can just throw them into your stock pot or crock pot, whatever you've got, and they will absorb the liquid as they cook. So let us begin getting everything into our pot here. First, we will get our leftover ham. It's going to just fall off the bone as it cooks, so I'm just going to put it in just like that. This is such a simple thing to do with your leftover ham, and it's so good. I'm going to put the juices because those are good too, especially if you have like a honey baked ham or something like that that's got the cinnamon and the sugar and that kind of stuff. Now I've got a 1 pound package of white beans. Whatever kind of beans you like, you can use. Most of the time I use 15 beans, but I didn't have any 15 bean soup mix today. And then we've got a nice large onion chopped. However many carrots you'd like to add. My husband likes carrots, so I put a few in there. I really love celery, so I chopped up the heart of the celery and a couple of extra ribs. I think the celery heart with the little leaves and everything has such a good flavor. So into the pot that will go. And we're going to add some bulbs of garlic. I just put them in whole because they're going to cook all day. And garlic is a very delicate spice. You may not think so because it has such a strong smell, but the aromatic essence of the garlic tends to dissipate pretty quickly. So I like to put them in whole when I'm having something that cooks for a long time. That way it'll slowly release the fragrance into the dish and it won't dissipate. All right, next we're going to add either water or broth, whatever you prefer. I'm going to use my broth from 2021. It's got a little bit of fat cap on there, but that's all right. And I will undoubtedly need to add water to this as well, but I think the addition of the broth gives it a little extra oomph, a little extra nice flavor. Okay, quart number 2. And this is a 6-quart pot here. Well, I may take some of those big fat hunks off of there. We don't need that many. A little bit doesn't hurt. Fat is flavor, so that'll give us nice flavor, but I don't want all of it in there. Okay, and then we'll just add water, enough to fill this about to you know, this lower edge of the pot here. We're almost there. I probably just need maybe a few cups, 2 or 3 cups. Alrighty, so I've added some water to kind of rinse out my broth. There we go. Okay, now this is ready to go. It's as easy as that. You can add extra spices in there if you'd like to. I generally don't add any salt because the ham is already pretty naturally salty, but you could add pepper. Peppercorns would be good. You could add thyme, you could add rosemary, whatever you like. And I'm just going to keep it simple today, just garlic and the vegetables. Alrighty, so let's turn this on. Now there are a couple of options for when you're cooking in this Dutch oven. You can use the slow cook function. Very simple. It has a preset temperature, and all you do is adjust the time and press start. You can use the sear saute to bring this to a boil initially, and then you can switch it over to the slow cook mode or to a manual mode. Or you can use the manual mode for the whole time, which is what I'm going to do. Manual, I want to cook this at a temperature of 190. Alrighty, and I'm going to be cooking it for about, probably 6 hours. So we just toggle down to the 6 hour mark. And once this is finished, it will automatically enter a keep warm mode. So that's nice. So once you've selected what you want to do, you just hit the start button and away you go. So I like all the various options you have on this, with this Dutch oven. And I've just had this on this manual mode at 190 for a few minutes, and there's already a little bit of simmering going on. I can hear it kind of bubbling there. You can see the bubbles forming, so it's warming up pretty quickly. So from a food safety standpoint, I don't think you have to worry too much. If you use the slow cook function, it cooks at 200 degrees, but I want it just a little bit lower at 190. Now, if you missed yesterday's video, I introduced you to this Instant Pot Dutch Oven. That was the first time I used it. And I used it on the saute mode just to make a quick soup. It's a chicken gnocchi soup. So if you'd like to check that out, I'll put a link up in the corner. It comes with a recipe book. Now, of course, you can download their app and get a lot more recipes, but this has some recipes specific to using this machine. For instance, cooking dinner rolls. You really wouldn't do that in an Instant Pot. And they have a good recipe for carnitas I thought I'd give a try. Fish stew, no knead bread, fettuccine, pot roast, spare ribs, chicken dinner. So a nice basic little cookbook with a lot of good recipes that you would actually probably use. Here's the picture for the carnitas. They give you a little method for making pickled red onion along with the pork. So a nice cookbook, you know, small but useful. And then of course there's the instruction manual, and that takes you through all of the functions and all the parts of the machine. There's all the picture of the included accessories and how to use the sear saute, how to use the slow cook, and it gives you the temps that it cooks at. The manual mode, there are two manual modes you can use. One is at a lower temperature than the other. And the keep warm function. Now they don't tell you this, but I did hold my soup yesterday on keep warm, and I tested it after about 3 hours on keep warm, and the soup was 150 degrees. So above 140 is considered to be safe to keep your food at in a buffet type setting. Cleaning, troubleshooting. So yeah, now I paid full price for this machine. I did not get it free, and I'm giving you my honest opinion of it. And so far, I really like it. I think it's a good deal. What you would pay for this whole setup here, sometimes you would pay that just for a cast iron pot. So there's that consideration. And you can use this cast iron pot separately if you want to just put it in your oven. It's a 6-quart Dutch oven. Okay, we have been cooking here for about 7 hours. And I have a granddaughter visiting and she's hungry. So this is how it looks. Very delicious. It smells awesome. My son came over to drop off my granddaughter and stopped at the front door and said, "Wow, it smells good in here." So all you have to do is take your fork and kind of, you know, shred the ham a little bit. It comes apart really easily. I'm going to leave the bone in here and I'm going to let this continue to slow cook for a little bit longer because I think that will just make it better. There's my bone. So we're just going to let it keep cooking and I'm going to give my granddaughter some beans, bowl of soup here, a little bit of ham. It does smell really awesome. Look at there. So there it is. Good enough to serve your 5-year-old grandchild. Good enough to serve your whole family. And I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you'll hit the like button, subscribe to my channel. Be sure to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified every time I upload a new video. I'm thinking of possibly doing a review on this instant Dutch oven. So if you'd like to see that, let me know in the comments below. And if you do, I'll take a few moments to just do a special video just to review this appliance. I think it's great. All right, take care and we'll talk to you all again next time. Bye-bye.